Hey guys, this is Jonathan, and this is why I drive a 2020 Lotus Evora GT. I needed to find basically a daily that was also a manual and reliable. And that's a very short list of cars. So Lotus was the only one that I thought that would just suit the best. I could have bought a GT4, I could have, but everyone has a Porsche. No one has a Lotus, you know, and that will actually try to daily it. So that's why I chose it, really. It's just so unique. I chose blue because it's my favorite color. But it was so hard to find one in blue. I found out they only made 1 of 9 in manual and blue of this particular color. It's just more unique than any other car. It's just a raw analog feeling. And I just absolutely love driving. Like, I put so much miles on this car since new. I bought it at 1,000 miles in February of this year. It now has 29,000 miles. Alright, so it's just my favorite thing to do, and I'm just gonna keep going until it probably hits 100, 200k. I'm not gonna give a damn about that and just keep having fun with it. It's special because it's simple, and that, like, it gives a weird, like, amazing feeling. Every time I get in it, I just smile. Like, all my problems go away, you know? It's the most special thing. You can't even describe it. It's that feeling when you see a really cool car on the road and you just feel happy, you know, undescribable happiness that just car guys understand, but no one else will. The coolest thing I've done so far is probably just add my radar detectors and my dash cam. That was the first thing I installed. And like some rim stripes, except they got taken out when I changed tires, unfortunately. And just small cosmetic changes. Like, mechanically, there's nothing I want to ever do to the car. It's just perfect the way it is, you know? But making small little touches just makes it a little more special. Oh man, it is so much weird reactions I get every time I show up anywhere, especially where it's like, most people don't know what Lotus is, and they look at my car, they're like, oh, is that a Ferrari? Wait, no, wait, McLaren? Corvette, I can't even tell. Some other brands, they just have a certain stigma to them, like Ferrari, Lamborghini. Like, you kind of expect them to be a little bit, you know? But when you see a Lotus go down the street, you're like, yes, that's cool, you know? Because you just don't see it. Okay, so top speed of the car is rated for 188. I went 180, and I was scared out of my mind going that fast in that car. But it was the most fun I ever had. So the downside of having a rare car is that once people know you, they know you. So I can't go, like, do donuts. I can't do anything that would just ruin my image or of image of Lotus.
Redline 7000, I can tell you this car is very driver focused. This is my first,
It's a weird startup process.
I was gonna say, where's the keys at?
Right here, and then there's a push engine start.
All right, so
is it like the S2000?
It's like this. So that's lock, unlock, and the trunk, right?
Okay.
You gotta unlock the car, put the keys in, clutch in, then press start.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's weird. Good luck.
All right, so we are in the 2020 Lotus Evora GT. Jonathan's so kind to let us drive it, and I'm just telling you guys right now, I can feel that this car is very driver focused. Clutch super stiff, roofline super low, but you have clear visibility. Obviously there's no back windows, but your front view is actually really, really nice. Seat actually is kind of high. Doesn't sit you on the floor like an S2000, but this clutch is so stiff.
Oh,
I can feel it. I can feel it. This car is so smooth. It feels very nimble, and I'm literally just starting to drive
it. Watch out for that.
I see that pothole. That's called a tuner eye. You see the pothole, you avoid it. So it's raining today. Can't get onto it kind of how I would want to. But I can tell you right now, just from getting on this main road, everything about this vehicle is tight. It has a Toyota motor, engines in the back. It feels very planted. It feels very solid. It feels very smooth. I'm gonna get on it just a little bit. Just a little bit.
Sure, here we go.
Not right now. Oh, oh, oh. Okay.
Give me a second.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I can feel that power, and I'm not even into the power band yet, but the power is very linear. It's not like a VTEC or a turbo that kicks in at a certain point. The car feels very...
It's just kind of like a straight, like...
Yes, the power just keeps going up. Very linear, very linear. I like it a lot. It's reminiscent of, you know, kind of like a high-powered V6 or a V8, where the power is just always there. Everything about it's very smooth. Now, I will say this. The transmission in this car feels, it's not like an S2000 smooth. It's not that it's not smooth either, but it's very notchy. It goes doo-doo, 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 doo-doo. So, yeah, I
like
really
it's not smooth, like it's not like zoom, zoom.
Yeah, it's not like a stock. Like, it's not like an S2000, you know, transmission.
Right.
You know, and I always compare it to that because that's like one of the benchmarks of trannies and shifting and stuff. So, but it's still very smooth. The power delivery is really nice. It reminds me a lot of the NSX. I test drove a 90s NSX a while ago when we were filming for AMIGOS. And I prefer the seating of this over the NSX, but the power delivery is very similar. This has more power than the NSX, you can feel it, but the way it delivers it, the way the torque hits is very similar to me to the NSX. I like it a lot. I like it a lot. This is really, really nice. Very smooth. Suspension is not too stiff. Let's see if I can get on it real quick. That's even in the rain. Super smooth. Car is super smooth. I give it a thumbs up. Handling is nice. That turning radius is so nice. It feels so nice and planted. It's just, the Lotus Evora is a remarkable car. I definitely recommend it.
For sure.
If you have $90,000, go buy yourself a 2020 Lotus Evora.
If you can get one.
If you can find one. Oh yeah, I like it.
Thanks for tuning in. Check out the trailer to 4 AMIGOS. I'ma go vibe, I'm fuck all my mood. I'm a gangster, so shy, God,
Leo, get the door.
Got it.
Sometimes, you have to become the monster to save the ones you love.
Your mother's labs came back in. The cancer is spreading fast. She does need surgery. Without that payment, tomorrow she's going to be discharged.
In 2 days, we're gonna rob Chino.
Come on, Chino! God! Come on, man! I have a family! Don't do this shit, man!
I mean, there's gotta be another way.
There is no other way, Leo! If we don't rob Chino right now, my mom is as good as dead!